Yeah. Let us acknowledge reading from the Book of Wisdom. The splendid and unfading is wisdom. And she's readily perceived by those who love her and found by those who seek her. She has to make herself known in anticipation of her desire. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed. For he shall find her sitting by his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence. And whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care.
parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there will not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
regular fasting has been my prayer partner for decades. Fasting, I celebrate. Father Anthony, we were together yesterday, and I saw the grace of God right into us. And may that grace continue to flow in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Another friend of mine that I lost over the years because I migrated to the United States, he found me. Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 and 14. We do not want you to be unaware. Some translations use ignorant, unwise, unperceiving. We do not want you to be ignorant or unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that we may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus Christ, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Turn to somebody and say, people fall asleep. Amen. Finally, to the gospel. Matthew chapter 25, verse 12 and 13. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, Lord, Lord, open the door for us. But he said in reply, Amen, which is categorical. Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you do not know the day nor the hour. Then the Bible said, then the can be very hard to write, especially you packing yourself while you drop new clothes for the party, and then you can't travel again, and then you start blaming yourself. Maybe it was because I took extra time on the middle. Maybe because I didn't move up on time, I had to drive into a gas station to get gas while I had a flight to catch up that very day. In all manner of excuses, people need. But then those excuses don't open the door when it's closed. Please help me tell somebody the door can be locked. So you don't have unlimited access, friends. We don't have unlimited access. And it's a beautiful day for us in the old harvest, but I will not want the harvest to overshadow the importance of the message that the Lord is presenting to the church today. And the Bible says, he who has ears, let him listen to what the Spirit is saying to the churches. Thank God you are here. Thank God for hearing this word. Thank God this word is for you and for me. And thank God for reasons to thank God, because we still have
Antoninus. We are heading towards the end of the liturgical year. In the next 2 weeks, the feast of Christ, the Universal King. And all the meetings will be happening today, the 22nd, the 23rd, and 24th Sundays of the year. Will be talking to us about the end of things. It's important to talk about the end of things. Because often, we get engrossed in the journey of life that we forget that we are here but for a short time. When we celebrate All Saints and All Souls, it reminds us that we are pilgrims. Those of us who are still here, we are the church militant, we are still on our way. So this place is not a permanent place. I remember that song. I'm not sure if I know the lyrics very well, but Ken can help me. This world is not my home. I'm just a passing man. My treasures are in gold, somewhere beyond the sky. The angels cover me from heaven so under, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. When we see in appearance, it looks as if it's an occasional thing, but it should be a daily song, because it puts up on our feet. It reminds us that we are on a time here. That is the central message of the gospel of today. The parable of the virgins concluded by saying you have to stay awake because you're not here forever, you're a waiter. The bridegroom is about to return, and your return at his time, not at your time. And if you are not there, then you lose out. The second reading echoed the same thing. Paul writing to the Thessalonians trying to comfort them about those who have gone ahead of us. I don't think there is anyone of us here who will not be able to identify somebody you know or have heard about who has passed on. At least your great-great-grandfather has passed on. Two of us. Alright. So even if you see your grandparents, your great-great-grandfather and grandmother have gone ahead of you, so somebody who will live it. In some we have classmates who have gone ahead of us. We have friends, colleagues, those whom you had appointments with this year who have gone ahead of us. And that is the reality of our life. And so when the scripture presents us, the urgency of our standing ready as believers and as Christians is at the center of the message of Christ who came to take us. To be able to connect that which is important to me, because when you Remember the bone of contention in the gospel was the oil. If you need the oil, you go to the anointed one. Because you need the oil. Please let me tell somebody you need the oil. Amen. We seek him because he's the bearer who carries the oil of life, the oil that keeps us safe. Let me show you three things that the oil does in the Old Testament. Number one, oil was a source of healing. Jeremiah talked about the balm of Gilead. James said, if anyone is sick, let them call upon the elders of the church so they can anoint the one to heal him. When the Good Samaritan was attending to the man who was beaten up, the Bible said he poured oil on his wounds. We seek Jesus because he has the oil that heals our brokenness. The thing that can be burning, that can stop you from crossing the gate, who come behind when the doors have been locked, are the things that flow from our brokenness as human beings. By seeing we all are broken, and we need him who was wounded that we may be healed. He's the balm that suits our wounds. So that in the journey of life when we are broken, we are someone we can go to and he say, oh, my son, your sins are forgiven. He heals the wounds of our soul and even of our body with the oil. He has the oil. Please help me tell our brothers, we need the oil. Now in the gospel, we are told that they needed the oil to fuel their light. If you go to Exodus 25, from verse number 6, and Exodus 27, the Bible had instructed the Israelites to make sure that they bring oil into the house of God. It was a requirement. You need to have oil so that you have light when you walk the Lord. And Jesus is the light of the world. You need oil. You need to align with him for his light to show the way, to radiate on you as you're walking through the valleys of the shadow of death. Because there are a lot of things in the valley that can take you down. But the Bible says the only assurance is you are there, but you are proof, and you are starved to give the comfort. Else, you perish in the valley of the shadow of death. These are your tears. My friends, there are a lot of things in the world that is casting shadow and darkness upon the souls of believers, especially the elect. That's why priests are targets. Nuns are targets. True Christians are targets. The enemy wants to cast a shadow over you and steal you away from the pathway of salvation. So you need the light, you need the oil. Tell somebody, I need the oil. If you have the oil, you are healed. If you have the oil, your light illumines the way. If you have the oil, my dear friends, in times of weakness, you are in power. Psalm 89, verse 20, I have found David, my servant, and with the oil of gladness have I anointed him. Psalm 23, verse 5, he has anointed my head with oil, and my cup overflows. The strength to fight on in the journey of life and to stay awake, because by that time the Bible says, while the bridegroom was delayed coming, they fell asleep. We have that capacity. Everybody falls asleep. But if you have the oil, you wake up and then you can ignite your light again. But if you fall asleep and you wake up and there is no oil, then you go in search, and by the time you come back, the door will be locked. continued their journey until they found Jesus. People who see Jesus do so intentionally is not something that you borrow. That was the reason when it was time for the oil to continue. The foolish ones. I don't intend to waste your time today. I would have talked that little bit about when the Bible calls someone foolish. Because you know Jesus said, call one fool, right? But then in the book of Psalms, he just said, the fool has said in his heart, there is no God above. Whenever
hey!
insurance would tell you, well, because of that day you were driving, you looked as if you were about to sleep, therefore we're not going to pay you your insurance remittances.
This is not a treasure for yourself, cattle, because where your treasure is, there will your heart be, there you will see. And so when you invest in God, your heart is in God, because you know you have invested in it. There's a connection between you and your God. Not only the appreciation that he has given you, but then I invest in God because I seek him with all my heart. I have renewed within me for blessed assurance. And finally, you invest in God because you realize that it is my duty, my Christian duty, as a mature person, an adult, to take care of my family. Paul wrote to Timothy in 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 1, he said, anyone who cannot take care of his relatives should be considered worse than an unbeliever. Have you ever heard that before? Because, okay, let's make this image. I don't know whether you're in a family that have trained their children, and the children graduated from college, and maybe they are living in the commonwealth. House bought by their parents, most probably enough, and they make money, and then they buy all manner of posh cars and drive around, but never remember to take care of their parents. Never remember to say Happy Mother's Day, Happy Father's Day. Never remember to come home for Thanksgiving. Whenever you want to go home, my dad friends who are going to California, from there to Dubai, to Paris, and so on and so forth. When your friend tells you that kind of story about their children, what do you think about those children? You think they are well off, they are doing well? Nobody praises that kind of children. And my culture is also treating me for life. I don't know how to translate it. It has no English. He has no English equivalent, so please excuse me. When the person is grown up and making all the money, then you don't care about the flat house and about the mother's house and things are dilapidated, and your aged parents, nobody takes care of them. Maybe they are even checking into a nursing home because you don't have time for your parents.
Families think you got it wrong. You were not well trained. My friends, you must begin to reason that we as Christians who come to church, get all the blessings of God in church, and we don't think we owe God the duty to support the whole organization in this church. Some of us who are baptizing, wedding here, worshiping here, what kind of commitment do you have in keeping the lights in this church running? This is a day to return home as an adult child that is well trained to say, God, thank you, and this light must not go out, the utilities must be paid, and this church must continue to grow. And as we do so, may the God in heaven bless us abundantly. Beyond what we can think of as we imagine. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah.
And the church will shout it louder.
Appropriate it and made it our own.
Let us pray not only for the grace to make the world of God but to be our own, as to seek Christ with all our hearts, for we need the one to be praised, so as not to debate on that day. Let us also pray for all the needs of our lives and families and the needs of our church, and for a joyful and successful week of Thanksgiving and harvest.
For Pope Francis, Cardinal Tolkien, all the bishops and priests, may the Holy Spirit lead them in the difficult task of reforming and guiding the church on the sure path to heaven. We pray to the
Lord. Lord, hear our prayers.
For the church, as she awaits the arrival of the bridegroom, that amidst the world's darkness, she may ever carry the oil of the light of the gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
As we daily witness the futile and the tragic death and disappearance of so many innocent men, women, and children, we pray to Jesus, the Prince of Peace, for the end to wars in Israel and Gaza, and Ukraine, and for Christ's peace in all hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for the wisdom recognize that Jesus, the bridegroom, is already with us in the Eucharist. May we not be found wanting to see a great union with him. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We thank the Lord for this wonderful celebration of our Thanksgiving harvest. May this be a beautiful occasion to give glory to God and build our community in greater unity and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayers. We pray for the Lord's blessings on all nations represented here today, especially as we will be processing with our flags and the offering of nations. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray for those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, that they may experience the holy touch of our blessed Lord. We especially pray for Brendan Abel, Elder Asbury Abel, Chimenzi Abel, Sandy Contra, Teresa Lista, Rosemary Joseph, Mary Joseph, Maricho Matos, Sony Taylor, and all sick. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
In this month of November, we increase our prayers for the souls in purgatory, especially members of our family and mind, that through our prayers and sacrifices, united to the sacrifice of the Mass, we may enter into the glory of heaven. We especially pray for Brian Luba, Agustin Agnubita, Dorothy Joseph Oxford, Antonia Leggi Edwards, Richard Carey, Patience Edwards, Charity Aparuli, and Brenda Joseph. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the intentions we hold in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our missions around the world in Sudan and other parts of Africa and the world and Southern. For the war against the Church and the Throne of God, even in the civilized world, in the Western world. And God, bring us faithfully back. For all who are going to make special donations, all who step out as adult members of our church family, and adult sons and daughters of God who want to show gratitude of the Father's house, who want to show gratitude in recognizing that everything they have has come from God, who want to connect with Jesus to have their hearts through their treasures now. That our blessed Mother Mary will continue to intercede for them and for us all and for our church. The one who made a generous donation of our womb and our only son to God in Christ Jesus. That she who understands being generous to God and who the world calls. by the power of the Holy Spirit, stay in us and abide. It's time for the flag offerings, and you know how it's going to be.
hallowed.
Hold my mind.
celebrating the mystery, the passion of the Lord's Son, we may only
loving devotion, grant this through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Thank you.
to his second coming, offering thanksgiving this holy living sacrifice. Look upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body and one spirit in Christ.
May you make a voice and continue our offering to you, so that we will obtain an inheritance which dwell in it, especially the words that have read in Mary, Mother of God, with this judgment of hearts, which you have listened to the portions of the glorious bodies, Saint Leo, Saint Antoninus, and with all sins of whose constant intercession in your presence, we are offended.
From sin and safe from all, as well as the blessed hope in the Look not on our sins, but on the faith of the church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will. You will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a sign. Peace of our Christ and the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you.
Chief to us, with our greatest appreciation, 30 years ago.
each of the honorees at our Thanksgiving harvest celebration downstairs. In fact, I'm going to ask right in your place if you would stand up. That's the honorees, if you would stand up. Honorary sponsor, excuse me, I didn't say that correctly. Honorary sponsor, please stand up. Thanks be to God. Right. And some people are working downstairs. In fact, I'm going to bring you forward. Come on up here. I'll give it to you downstairs for the rest of the Lord's blessing upon you. Jesus, pour out your grace upon these ribbons and upon your people who we celebrate in these various ways. Bless them. Shower with your blessings. And may this ribbon that they wear be a sign of what you have done for them and their praise and thanksgiving back to you. Jesus Christ the Lord, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We ask that before you go downstairs, that you would come forward to receive those ribbons. And you may actually receive them while I make a couple of announcements now. So you may come forward for those. That would be even better. Just come forward and receive. As those ribbons are given out, I just want to make a thank you. God bless you. God bless you. Those honorees. Kevin and Julian.
Our community is to welcome our guests here to church.
be praise and worship, pray with those seeking healing and consolation of Jesus. Come and help, especially the healing and prayer ministries. It's a great opportunity for outreach and people. And if you can come, please see me after Mass, so we might just know what we're working on. Immediately after Mass, I invite you to go down each of these stairs, this one or that one, through each of the sacristies to come for our Thanksgiving harvest festivities, lunch. The feast has been prepared for you with great love and devotion to God and to each other. And we are very grateful. And finally, thank you, Father Albert, for coming to bless us and being so good.
God is good
all the time.
That's too low for me. God is good
all the time.
I can't witness somebody. Raise your hand. Some witness to the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And I want to thank my brother priest, especially Father Joe, for thanking me for inviting me over and bring our name. I want to join the parish in bearing witness and also testify to the today in the person of Evelyn Martis. Not just her consistency, but she carries her family along. Children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren. Over the years, consistency is a real. And the same for Chief Michael Akinyemi. He comes consistent with his family, sons and daughters, sons-in-law and daughters-in-law, children and grandchildren, please us celebrate that man of God for his people. I tap into their consistency and their love for God to pray that God will grant us longevity in serving Him with the right heart and mind and with all the blessings we deserve in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This is my home, this is my family. Then also I have a commitment where God has given me some assignment to do for Him. So I need to go there immediately. But as a member of this family, I'm praying for a time when I will call Father Joe on the phone and say, how much does it cost to pay for utilities in a month? And he tells me, and I'll pay him for as much, many months as I can. But for now, the support of things that I've raised have been martyrs. And she's my beloved, and our church family, I personally, together with my brother priest, to make a donation in support of our harvest of $1,000.
Bless.
St. Michael is the Archangel.
Defend us.
Okay, let's go.